On the day of the Hindu wedding, the bride is worshipped as Mahalakshmi. And so this evening, indirectly, our bride, she is paying obeisance to the lotus-like feet of the universal mother, Devi Gauri. And so while performing these rituals, we pray to the goddess who dwells in the heaven, that may she illumine the pathway of the bride. And so, oblations of love, they're being offered to Gauri Mata.
I have known Jovanna for 32 years, and I can definitely say that I have felt God's favor in her presence. In fact, there may be times that I felt that this may be God's favorite. Just look at her, blessed with stunning beauty, charm, intelligence, wit, and a passion for life. But not only does she exhibit the grace of God, she pours out grace and favor to all close and dear to her. Her generosity is immeasurable, and her kindness knows no boundaries.
So my speech today will be like a miniskirt, long enough to cover the essentials and short enough to hold your attention. So as you see, some of my friends came up here, the guys came up, and I'll just tell you the story on how I met Jovanna. Four years ago, we were playing carnival. Jovanna comes up, takes out her boots, she had on her long striped socks, sat down there, lied on and put her foot straight across my chest. And I don't know who is this character with some nasty toe jab, striped socks. And that's where it started.
I've heard many grooms quote this saying on the wedding day, and I'm sure you've heard it before. It goes like this: don't walk behind me, I may not lead. Don't walk in front of me, I may not follow. Just walk beside me and be my friend.
So next year, I'm in bliss and I'm looking from the front truck to the back truck to see if I can see who this person is. Finally found her at lunchtime crossing the road. She was with Brianna again. I tapped on her shoulder and she looked at me and she was like, hi, and she was like, hi, and I like, bliss. Lunch park, striped socks last year. She's like, oh, okay, and she kind of just brushed me off and went away. But after knowing her, she said that moment actually triggered something in her, that someone could remember that fine detail about her.
So let's lift our glasses to Arvin and Jovanna. May God continue to pour out his grace to you. And may you continue to walk beside each other as partners and friends for life. Cheers.
Arvin's story reads like a good novel or a good Indian movie. You know, action, adventure, drama, suspense, you name it, he's experienced it. I think the only piece missing was the love story part of it, which is complete now. So he's really come full circle.
Final straw for this was we went to cricket with my other best friend, Gaul, and then while we were looking at cricket, Jovanna turned around and our eyes met. And I looked at her and I'm like, I know you from somewhere. And she started chatting. She said, I know you from somewhere. 8-9 months from there, we were in Paris, proposed, and then yeah, after that, we here, married.
Just so that you know, them force me to go up. Mom and Uncle Arvin, you're like the best.
Is like a house, and when a bulb blew, you don't buy a new house, you just change the bulb.
Arvin, as a friend, he is a friend that would drop everything to come and support our friends in need. And all I have to say is that if he takes care of his friends like that, I think you're in really great hands.